So before going to start the exclusive topic of right shares and bonus shares, but we all want to know that the preliminary topics of, right, that we have to recall, then only it is easy to cope up with your the regular topic what we are going to discuss soon, right? So in generally, suppose Meena Lochini is she is going to start a particular business, right? Can you anyone would possible to give what are all the terms or forms which is possible to start your business? I think the first one, it is called sole proprietorship. This is the one, only one individual, he or she is going to contribute a capital. So starting the business operations, whether it is a profit or it is a loss, right, the particular person itself is going to enjoy, and other both the way, positive or negative aspect. The second form of your business, it is called partnership. We discussed a minimum requirement, at least a couple of members and mutual consent by investing a capital to start a partnership business, right? Based upon the investment of your capital, they are decided going to share their profit and losses, or otherwise they are going to be used in a equal ratio manner. So all the provisions you all aware under the Partnership Act 1932 already, now it is revised. Then the third forms of your business, it is called a corporation, right? It is an individual entity. They are all having for the own rights, right? The corporation, it is very, very important, because the 50 to 60% of whatever the discussion we are going to make, it is exclusively from the corporation. Then another forms of business terms, it is called a limited liability company. Now in India, we are call it as a liability, limited company. But in except India and few other countries, all the countries in the world, they are call it as a limited liability company, right? If it is a private limited company, right, they are going for limited liabilities, because whoever is the in charge or he is the stakeholder of a particular firm, particular business, right, he is also acting as one among the member. The liability is within the radius of the company's purview, not beyond the personal assets. The same manner, it is a public limited company, right? That is a fourth form, is limited liability company. The last one, the last one is cooperative, right? They want to do for the services for the local people, right? Therefore, only the group of people or group of individual, or otherwise I can say that is a body of individuals, they are going to jointly start with a purview of doing some services for the public. I think all you are aware. So there are so many cooperative societies which are under the purview as per the norms of the state government of India, state government of Tamil Nadu. Not only for Tamil Nadu, but almost all other states also having for the same cooperative. They are doing some services, for example, issuing a loans to the agricultural purposes, or issuing loans for the some other purposes which is related to upliftment of the agricultural or farmers. So this is the four forms of our business. One is sole proprietor, the second one partnership, the third one is corporation, the fourth one is limited liability company, the last one is cooperative. These are all the five forms of business. The next thing is, what do you mean by business, right? So I invested a capital, right? There is some amount of money, right? So what you are going to be, whatever the resources are having in a particular company or a firm, that resources you are going to use it in a proper manner to get some output called a finished product. With that, we are going to do some sales and other aspects in terms of earning a revenue. whatever it is, even a sole proprietor or a partnership or a corporation or whatever it is, that ultimate objective is they want to earn a profit. Then when it is possible to earn a profit, obviously, whatever the resources which are there, sir, I have a machinery I purchased and invested for a huge amount of money. Using that machinery, you are going to produce or manufacture some things. Otherwise, it is very difficult to earn. So whatever the resources, that resource is going to be used in a proper way in terms of making a finished one. So with that, we are going to earn a revenue, that revenue which is going to be treated as a part of your business profit. Out of all these, now we are going to focus only on the corporation. Under corporation, the second aspect is public limited company. I think all you are aware. So public limited company, what is the procedure we have to follow? So what kind of conditions when we are going to convert into the public limited company? All things you are already aware, because you are a few people are from the commerce background, you already studied. I don't want to discuss much more things. But anyway, but in general term is, can you give me any one, right? What do you mean by share? Will it possible to give your answer? What exactly mean by share? What exactly Meenalochani is thinking, right? What exactly mean by, right, share? You look at, if an individual, I am going to start my business. Sir, I have my own money, so I am going to contribute the whole amount, whatever the business which I want to start. Even the partnership business, I need for 1 lakh rupee to start a particular business, but I don't have money. Therefore, I am joined with my friend. Equally, they are going to contribute. But in a limited company, right? So in a company, they want to generate the huge amount of capital. No one is ready to give, or otherwise there is no sources. Even I tried for the third party sources also, but no one is ready. In that situation, right, the public limited company, they are going to issue the SAS to the public, right? So a public, or otherwise in other manner may possible, right, they are going to get the money from the shareholder. So therefore, the share is a indivisible unit, right, of capital. I need for 1 lakh rupees capital, right? I am going to issue 10,000 shares, per share value is 10 rupees. Therefore, so I am going to collect this 10 rupees from each one of the public, those who are seeking or those who are interested to invest in our company, right? That is why the share is an indivisible unit of your capital, right? And providing as well as expressing an ultimate relationship between the company as well as and the shareholders. And the shareholder, because I am a shareholder, right? I am having for the one share, or otherwise I am having for the very few shares, or I purchased for the 100 share or whatever it may be. You are also acting as a part of one among the owner, or maybe acting as a shareholder of a particular company. You are having for the some of the rights that depends upon what kind of shares which you are purchased. Therefore, the share is a indivisible unit. Therefore, the share is the indivisible unit of your capital. So, meanwhile, I'm also sharing for some of the PPT which is going to help you all. You look at, here I have given for the exact definition what is mean by share. As I mentioned, it is a share is an indivisible unit, or otherwise it is a single unit of your ownership. Right? Because you want to showcase your interest. Otherwise, you are not a member of a particular organization or particular company. Because when you are going to invest, a money because I don't have much money, but I'm going to buy a particular amount of share. That is why we mentioned it is a share is a single unit of ownership in a particular company or a financial asset. Right. The second term is, what do you mean by stock? Because sometimes we are colloquially we are using, sir, I bought a share from ITC company. Sometimes we are colloquially speaking, sir, I have a shares of, sir, I have a stock of a particular company. Or otherwise, I'm having a collectively a different company share all. Because there has some differences between the share and the stock. Because I can say that very exactly the collection of shares you may be considered as a stock. Because say for example, the ITC, it is a company which is going to issue the shares to the public. Right? I am going to purchase one share or 10 share. You are the shareholder of a particular company. Right? You are also having some of the rights. But a stock, it is totally different. Right? Stock in generally what we are telling us, it is if it is in the financial terms, it is called opening stock, closing stock, work in progress, whatever the stock which are holding. But in terms of shares, right, I am having a shares of ITC, I am having a shares of Wipro, I am having a shares of some other company. So I purchased, here I purchased for 5 shares, there I purchased for 5 shares, there I purchased for. So all these 5 shares you are going to collectively known, what is a simple understanding, it is called as a stock. Right? But that is why we can say that a stock is a collectively, a stock is an aggregate of, right, a fully paid up shares, or otherwise is collectively known combination of all the shares what you are having, that we call it as a stock. The biggest difference is share, and I think you all aware there are several things which are involved when you want to issue a shares, right? Say for example, they fixed for the face value is 20 rupees, right? While the first call, right, you are going to collect 10 rupees from the stakeholder or stockholder, shareholder, that is called partially paid, right? The second called or the final call you are going to issue, in that you are going to get the remaining 10 rupees amount. So 10 plus 10, the total amount when you are going to get from the individual shareholder, then it is called fully paid up. So shares may be partially paid up as well as fully paid up. But a stock is not like that, because when you are having a stock of a particular company, right? So you paid, you purchased. So full amount you paid. So therefore, stock is always fully paid, right? There is no chances of a partially paid. So please keep in mind. But share is not like that, right? Today the particular company is issuing. So on the first call you are paying for partial amount. The second call you are paying for the another partial amount. So that is the biggest difference of a share. Therefore, so far what we discussed, what do you mean by share? A share is a indivisible unit of a particular capital required in a company, right? The exact definition I have given. But the stock is totally different. It is a collection of shares, I can say that, or an aggregation of the total or fully paid up shares of one company or more than one company, what you are held it. The second important difference between these two, shares may be partially paid or fully paid up shares, but stock is always fully paid. You paid and purchased either from the initial public offering or from some other way, or maybe the through the agent, whatever the mode which is possible. So all it is included. That is the second slide which is focusing on your stock, what we discussed. You take a look, your stock is a type of investment that represents ownership of a particular share. You look at the stock in a company means bundle of fully paid up shares put together for the convenience. That the same which I used for the word called, it is called a aggregate. The stock cannot be issued originally and can only be obtained by the conversion, right? But if the shares are fully paid up, as per the article what it was mentioned, accordingly they have to follow. So don't confuse with this. The simple is a collection of shares what you are having, right? So all it is fully paid up. So before going to discuss the difference between share and stock, there has some other things also we want to aware is. So probably all you are aware, different type of shares are there. Can you please anyone? What are all the different type of shares?
So dividend shares.
Dividend shares. The very first time I'm having hearing, it is a dividend share.
Equity shares.
Yes.
Equity.
Yes. Equity shares. Yes. These two shares we are frequently we are using. Right? We are we heard about. Right? One it is called a preference shares. The second one it is called equity shares. Right? And sometimes we also aware or heard about it is called a sweat shares. SWEAT. Sweat. Shares. This is a three different type of shares which is possible, but most probably 98% of the companies are receiving either preference or capital or equity share care. So equity shares or preference shares. There are very few existing companies, those who are going well, so that particular company only is issuing for SPAC shares. That is, it is a part of a equity shares. Under preference shares, there has several types are there. So may you all heard about cumulative, non-cumulative preference shares. Then participating and non-participating preference shares. Then convertible and non-convertible preference shares. The next redeemable and non-redeemable preference shares. So the company have to decide before going to issue the shares to the public what kind of form we are going to follow. Either it is a convertible or non-convertible, or redeemable or not possible to redeem, or participating or not participating. These are all the several things which is included under the preference shares. The next, sometimes the company may also issue the shares with a premium. Say for example, they fixed the face value is 10 rupees, but they included the premium value is 50 rupees. So the total share price in the public, it is a 60 rupees. I think you all are aware, right? So when I'm going to get the money from the shareholder inclusive of a premium, so what kind of accounts we have to follow? Because only the face value which is to be included, whatever the money which you are collected from the premium from the same shareholder, when I'm going to issue the shares to them, whatever the premium amount they collected, that premium amount cannot be included for declaring the dividend to the particular shareholder of your company, right? That premium amount should be used only for, right, issue of the bonus shares that we will discuss tomorrow, right? So the premium amount which is possible to utilize only for issuing the bonus shares, and whatever the expenses which may possible to write off, you please use that premium amount. Say for example, preliminary expenses write off, right? Preliminary expenses write off. Then I can say that when you are going to redemption of your debentures, when you are going to redemption of your preference shares, at that time this premium amount you please use it, but you cannot use to declaring the dividend, right? Dividend can possible to declare only by the help of the profits, what they earned during the particular year of a particular company. This is a one important thing, please keep in mind about the premium, right? Then, the next, equity shares, because this is a very important topic, because which is related to issue of bonus shares as well as the rights shares, please. Equity shares, otherwise we call it as a common shares, or otherwise we call it as ordinary shares. Otherwise we call it as a ordinary shares, common shares. But colloquially, we heard about it as a equity shares. Can anyone please tell me what is the difference between preference shares and dividend share? You look at this particular slide. You look at this particular slide, right? Probably what we discussed earlier, type of shares. There are two predominantly we are using, but other than that, the SWEAT, I told you. Preferences. What is the biggest difference between preference shares and equity shares? Preference shares normally having preferential rights. One is amount of dividend, it is fixed, that is a percentage, fixed amount of a percentage or amount is fixed. Then to repayment of capital on winding up. Okay, so please understand students, the preference shares only within 20 years if the company is going to wind up or otherwise they are going to repayment of and buyback of the existing shares what the shareholders have held. Okay, so beyond 20 years then only it is possible to issue the equity shares. So please understand between these two differences. So preference shares within 20 years, so they can get back or buy back the shares from the shareholder on paying the full amount of money as on the date of market value of a particular share. This is a main differences when they are going to issue the preference shares or when they are going to issue the equity shares, right? So the general definition you all aware, right? They have the fixed amount of dividend rate, they have the preferential right, as well as they have a chance to repayment of capital on winding up. Say for example, I am having 10 shares on the after at the time of a repayment of capital per share value is 1000 rupees. So therefore I am eligible to get 10,000 rupees exclusive of your dividend, because whatever the dividend which you received throughout this 20 years, that is totally different. But when you are going to surrendering your shares, then you can get the money from the company, that is possible in the preference shares. So therefore within 20 years they are going to wind up or the repayment of the capital. Equity shares is not like that. It is a simple, I can say that it is a going concern as much as, right? The other biggest difference while comparing to the preference shares. Look at the preference share dividend rate is fixed, but here equity shares dividend rate, it is not fixed. Okay. My company is earning higher profit, then I can eligible to get the higher dividend. If my company is under risk, I may not possible to get the dividend. Or otherwise, my company is going on average profit, then I can get for the average return in terms of dividend. That is the basic differences between the preference shares, right? Then the second one, ownership lies in the hands of the equity shareholder, because you purchased this share, right? You have the voting rights also, right? So whatever the decision is taken by the company, sometimes you may have opposition. That is a case happened for the Ramalinga Raju's case. I think all you are aware who is the Ramalinga Raju. He is the former managing director or otherwise chief managing director of Satyam Computers, right? So whatever the decision is taken by himself, It is totally opposed by the directors. Who are all the directors? He is elected among the shareholders, right? So this is a basic differences between preference shares and equity shares, right? But preference shares sometimes, whether the company is going moderate profit or higher profit, but you cannot get. Even company is going for moderate profit or less than the abnormal situation, but you can get the regular dividend because the dividend percentage is already fixed. Right? So the risk is very low, but in terms of equity shareholders, your risk is very high. The company is going good, you will receive the benefit. The company is not in the up to the situation, then obviously you will not get appropriate return. Right? This is a basic differences between preference shares and equity shares. But other than several forms, they may be used in colloquially, right? When not only for India, almost all over the country. I think, have you ever before heard the word called penny shares? P-E-N-N-Y, penny shares. Have you heard about ever before? Maybe there are very few heard about, maybe most of you are not aware about penny shares, right? The penny shares means the market, the share price is very, very low. So I decided I am going to purchase for that particular share. You have to wait at least a period of 2 years, 3 years, and sometimes for 5 years to get your return, right? So the penny shares, it is exclusively for the available at the low price, but the high risk. That is another term we are using under shares. It is a penny shares. The next is income shares. Income shares. Say, for example, I am ready to invest or I am ready to purchase Sun Direct or Sun TV shares because they are already established in the market, right? The market share price is always high. So therefore, I can get for some income shares. So that term also we are using. Then growth shares. I think probably, a month before of the lockdown, have you heard about the Yes Bank issue? Have you all heard about Yes Bank issue? Right there, the bank, particular bank faced for some problems. Right, when the problem which came into the public notice, immediately the share price of the particular bank falls down, right? Then immediately within 1 week or within 10 days, right, after the entire discussion, there are another company is ready to invest or ready to invest in terms of purchasing of S Bank shares, right? The very next week, immediately the price of the share, it is little increased. Say, for example, while the situation arises the very first moment, right? Say, for example, at the time market value is 25 rupees, immediately it came down to 10 rupees or 8 rupees. But the other company is ready to invest or take over in terms of purchasing of shares of S Bank. The very next day, or even I can say that the very same day, the market price of the particular company share, it is a little increased, right? So therefore, growth shares. So as a stakeholder or as a shareholder, you have to decide, right, based upon your analysis, which company is going good, which company's growth is going normal or good in the knowledge. So accordingly, you please invest in terms of purchasing of shares. Then the particular shares is called as a growth shares. In several other shares, other forms, other terms also we are using, what we call it as cyclical shares. This is also, it is a one term which is available, right? So therefore, because predominantly we heard about from day one, it is types of share is preference shares, equity shares. But other type of shares also, which is there, that existing company which is going to issue, right? So that is called sweat shares, right? Then penny shares, then growth shares, then income shares, then cyclical shares. These are all the terms which we are using, right? So whatever the terms other than preference shares and equity shares, whatever the term which we used, all these terms which is applicable only for the existing company, right? For the remaining issue, not for the initial public offering. Please understand, all of you, right? So these are all. Therefore, what so far we discussed? Business, right? Business is a purpose. The major objective is to profit motive. For that, whatever the resources which are available in your company or in your firm, that resources use be used in a proper manner, right? That is to be that what we discussed initially. It is called as a business, right? Then second, what we discussed are forms of your business, right? One is called a sole proprietorship. The second one, it is a partnership. The third one is a corporation. Then fourth one is limited liability. The last one that we discussed, it is a cooperative. These are all the forms you may keep whenever you are going to start your own business. The next we started with share capital. But before going to start with the share capital, right? What do you mean by share? Right? It is a one unit, or you are also one among the owner of that particular company. That's why I need for a huge amount of capital. So I am going to collect from each one of the individual by issuing a share. That is why we used to call it as a share, right? It is an indivisible unit of a particular capital what is required. Okay, there is a relationship between the company and also the shareholder of a particular company. Right, this is what we discussed. Then the next term what we used, it is called as a stock. Right, stock, it is a combination, or it is a collection, or it is an aggregate of the total shares what you are having. Right, the only biggest difference is share may be partially paid or fully paid up, but the stock is totally is a fully paid because you purchased, right? X company share, Y company share, Z company share, all the company share, or we are going to call it as, right, it is a, what do we call this, stock, right? Then another thing is share has a fixed denomination, that is called as a face value. The particular share is 10 rupees, that particular share is 20 rupees, but the stock is not like that. One share may have 20 rupees, the other share, other stock value may be 30 rupees, the other stock value may be 40 rupees, right? There is no fixed denomination. Then the next what we discussed, type of shares. Predominantly, we are using two things. One, it is called preference shares, right? The second type is equity share, preference shares, right? Within 20 years, the company is going to repay of capital from the shareholder at the time of winding up. So when that type of shares, what we call it as, it is called preference shares. In the preference shares, another two important thing is the dividend rate is fixed. Whether the company is earning for the higher profit or lower profit is not a problem, right? It is a fixed percentage of dividend rate, right? This is about preferences what we discussed. Then the next type of share, it is the equity shares, right? Which is going to be issued to the initial public offering, right? So here, whether it is a huge amount of profit if the company is earning during the day, then you will obviously get for the higher dividend. If it is a lesser, then you may be possible to get the lesser dividend, right? So here, whoever is having a shares of a particular company, you are also one among the ownership or owner of a particular company, right? So this is the differences what we discussed. Then the next, premium also. There is a possibility the company's growth is already there. Now they want to expand their business. Therefore, they are going to issue at the premium rate, right? Inclusive of a face value, right? The face value normally is included in the capital. The premium also going to be added in the capital, but normally the premium amount, you may not possible to use it for the declaration of dividend. Even the company is not earned a profit during a particular profit or less profit earned during a particular year. That particular amount which is going to be used only for issue of bonus shares or otherwise to write off some expenses what you want, only these two purpose, or otherwise any redeemable debenture or preference share In that situation, it may be used for the thus premium amount. Other than that, you cannot use it for any other mode. Meanwhile, as per the SEBI guidelines, when you are going to get the money inclusive of premium by issuing of shares, it is a must you have to keep the separate account. That is also, it is very important. Please note the student. That is also we discussed. Then equity shares, what we discussed, right? The same, I don't want to repeat once again, right? Then other forms of shares, it is called the SPITs, right? Maybe the company is going good, right? They want to, the existing company is going well. They are going to issue the shares for the top level people or otherwise internal members of the company. Otherwise, what be the term we are using? It is called ESOP, employee stock option, right? The same term we are using, employee stock option. Say for example, a particular person is working in the middle level, say for example, manager level, his salary is a little high. Instead of offering for the salary, they are giving for some shares also, right? After a certain period of time is elapsed, the employee can able to sell that particular share, get back the money. That is called the ESOP, otherwise we use it for the SPIT. Then another penny shares also we are telling us, low price availability in the market, but a high risk. And then growth shares, then income shares, right? These are all the some of the basic understanding, right? May help you all to get some exposure before going to discuss for the formal aspect of our bonus shares and right shares, right? So please take a look, right? What is share we discussed, what is stock we discussed. There has some of the differences between share and stock, right? It is an original issue. Stock you are already purchased, not an original issue. The shares will be fully paid up and partially paid up. The stock must always be fully paid up, right? As I said earlier, a share always a fixed denomination, but stock is not a fixed denomination, right? Registration of your share capital with the registrar, it is a must. I think you all aware, right? Earlier it was Companies Act 1956. Now we are following Companies Act. Now we are following Companies Act 2013. Yes, it is very important. But a stock is issued only after passing the special resolution already. So we don't want. A share has a definite number, but a stock has no such member, right? So this is the biggest basic differences between share and stock. So this, you people are already aware modes of issue of shares. For cash, at par, at premium, at a discount. Okay, sir, the first type for cash, it is exclusive of the very first time the company is offering. Otherwise, what is the term which you are came to know? It is called IPO, initial public offering, right? So you can use it at par. I fixed 10 rupees, the same value I am going to use it. At premium, I fixed face value is 10 rupees, but premium amount is included 40 rupees, therefore the share price is 50 at discount. Actually, I fixed initially 10 rupees per share, but now I discounted 2 rupees or 3 rupees and depends upon, right? This is exclusively for the very first time then company is going to issue the shares to the public. Then second mode that we are following for consideration other than cash, right shares. We will have a brief discussion soon. Then the buyback shares, right? Then employee stock option, what I spoke with you all little earlier. So these three we are going to be considered other than cash. Then type of shares we already discussed, we don't want. You look at the section 85 of the Companies Act 1956. Then share capital, you all aware, right? The share capital denotes the amount of capital to be raised for your business purpose, right? That amount of capital, how we are going to generating by issue of shares, right? Through the share, I am going to generate the money. Therefore, what we are using the word, it is called a share capital. Type of share capital, many all aware, there are certain times, but colloquially we are using for authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital, called up capital, uncalled capital. I think all you are aware about uncalled capital. Sir, partially, totally fixed for 10 rupees, but first call is 10, 10 rupees we collected. The second call I may not able to during some situation.
Time
So it is showing time up. It is showing time. Right, uncalled capital, paid up capital, and reserve capital. These are all the capital we are using the terms. Right, this already I discussed when the company is going to issue the preference shares and the equity shares. Then futures of equity share, as we discussed, there has a permanent in nature as long as equity shareholders are the actual owners of the company, as well as they are also facing for the little risk. Within 10 minutes, we will wind up, please. Equity shares are transferable, right? Suppose I am having today 10 shares, immediately I am going to, right, sell to the other fellow for the 5 shares. So it is equity shares is always transferable. Dividend payable to the equity shares already discussed now based on the profit, right? There is no fixed rate of dividend, right? They have the right of the control. The limited of liability of equity shareholder limited to the extent of the investment. Certain limit. You cannot buy for the, they may be fixed per shareholder, get only for the 100 shares or 200 shares. So initially, but during the stock trading, you may be buy, but initially, these are all the some of the futures you please keep in mind. There has some advantages as far as the shareholders' point of view. Equity shares are very liquid, can be easily to sold in the capital market. In case of high profit, you will get for the high return. Equity shareholders have a right to control of the management cup because based on the voting rights. The equity shareholders get the benefit in two ways: yearly dividend and appreciation in the value of their investment. This is exclusively the benefit which is going to be enjoyed from the shareholders' point of view. Then, in the company's point of view, there are the permanent source of capital because there is no winding up. During the winding up, we don't want to repay, right? It is a permanent capital. As long as the companies are there, they can keep it. They don't have any obligation regarding the payment of dividend because there is no fixed percentage. If the profit, then we will issue. Otherwise, no. Larger equity capital base increase credit worthiness of the company among the creditors and the investors. That is also right one kind of benefit the company may enjoy because all are the individual unit, right? Individual portion of money, right? So that's why the company is not able to face any problems. This is some benefit as per the company's point of view, right? There has some disadvantages also, right? Get the dividend only if the profit is earning. After deducting of the necessary taxes, whatever the interest we have to pay, therefore the dividend rate is always less. Equity shareholders are scattered and unorganized because nobody knows who are all there. Only the shareholders voluntarily came up and rise, then only we will come to know these are all the shareholders. There is no unity, therefore unable to exercise any effective control. Only the directors they are going to take for all the decisions. Equity shareholders bear the highest degree risk. Obviously, you all aware. Market price equity shares fluctuate very widely. Most occasions, during this pandemic situation, many of the shares, almost 95% of the company shares, are little down because of there is no progress. Similarly, if your company is going good, then no problem. If it is facing any problem, then obviously it is a high risk to the equity shareholders. Issue of fresh shares reduces the earning of existing shareholders. Of course, there is also one among the drawbacks of the shareholders' point of view. Before we wind up, the last one, disadvantage from the company's point of view. Cost of equity is the highest among all the sources of finance. All the sources of finance. Payment of dividend in equity shares not tax deductible expenditure. Please note the point. Therefore, whatever the dividend we received as per income tax section under section 10, it is fully exempted in the public point of view. But this dividend which is offered from the profit, therefore whatever the amount is declared as a dividend, for that also the particular company has to pay for the tax. That is a one disadvantage in the company's point of view. As compared to the other sources of finance, issue of equity shares involve higher floating expenses, higher floating expenses of brokerage, underwriting commission also. It is a very headache to the company's point of view. But even though these are all the some of the disadvantages from the company's point of view, there is no other go. When they want to run their business in the long run nature, they want to generate the huge amount of capital for their business, obviously they have to issue the shares from the to the public. Otherwise there is no possible to generate the fund, right? So probably we will wind up now. So we will continue the remaining to the next class.